we discussed today, can you do me a small favor and get that contract back to me by 4:30 this afternoon?
Okay. Do that. I love that reciprocity. Give me a little bit more stroke. Say, Claude, you give me some stroking and nurturing, and then go for the reciprocity.
Absolutely. So Claude, you know, I've made a decision. I want to work with you because, you know, you sound like a straightforward guy, and we're going to fix this whole thing. You know, we're going to take you out of your mom's basement and put you in this nice 3-bedroom apartment where, you know, the chihuahuas can just run there and be free. And, you know, you don't have to worry about anything. Just imagine for a moment. It's 4th of July and you're just, you know, like they have this nice common area and you're just having barbecue with the friends and the family. How do you feel about that?
Well, you know, to tell you the truth, it's getting a little annoying. I need to solve this problem.
I mean, annoying. It can't be that bad, you know, living with mom can't be that bad.
Are you kidding me? She doesn't knock on the door. There is no door. The door fell off the hinges the other day. Mom walked at the most inappropriate time.
But I mean, how old is she?
You know, mom's 94.
Oh my gosh. But she's probably, you know, like she won't bother you. But anyway, let me ask you this. So if we can solve this problem today and put you in this nice place on the next 30 days, that's not something you want to do.
Well, how do I know? Okay, let me take this a different direction.
Okay.
I don't know you or anything, and you're moving awfully fast. And how do I know I can trust you?
My wife said the same thing on our honeymoon. But you know what? And that's a great point. Thank you for bringing that up. You know, I wouldn't expect anything less from you. You know, like I can appreciate a guy that, you know, it's upfront, it's transparent, that wants to do business. Now, I get it. You know, we're moving awfully fast, but you want me to tell you the truth or lie to you?
Yeah, the truth. The truth.
You have a problem.
I know I do. I have a big problem.
And we can fix this. So, I mean, okay, I lost my train of thought.
You ended in a statement rather than a
question. Yes, and I have to end in a question. So, you know, that's a good
for a moment. Go into Guts 2.0.
Yeah, imagine for a moment, you know, we're able to, you know, fix this whole thing. Mom is not breaking in the room anymore at the most inappropriate time. And you guys have this privacy because how long you've been married?
Oh, God, we just had our 35th wedding anniversary.
So, I mean, you guys are newlyweds, so you need some privacy. So
we're still living in our mother, my mother's basement.
But can we reverse it? Because I know you're going to do it better than I mean, I know I got a problem, but how do I know that, I mean, you're moving too quick, man. How do I know that this is going to be the right decision or should I work with you?
I'm Mr. DQ. I do it all. I do everything quick. DQ. You came to me with a, hey, listen, how many years you've been in your mother-in-law's basement there?
Going on 15.
Stay another 15. It's cheap rent. It's not the most, it's a little damp in there and there's no privacy you said or anything like that. But you know, that's the state. That's the way things are today, right?
Yeah, I mean, I'll be honest with you, man.
I thought you were. Which part was less honest than
1%? 1% more honest. 101% honest.
I say stuff like that sometimes. By the way,
as long as you fix it, you can use humor and fix it. It works great. Works miracles. Yeah. I mean, how do I know this is gonna work out for me?
You don't know. Yeah, it's a good question. And maybe you don't want a guarantee or something like that. Do you? Would that make you more comfortable? Some kind of guarantee or something like that?
I mean, can you guarantee your results that I'm going to be able to live in this place and all of that?
This is a role play we never do. Thank you. This is a good one. The guarantee.
It works. I mean, we've done it, but we do it more for sales training. Because it's a very common question for people when they come for sales training more than real estate. But in real estate, you get that every now and then, and you got to be ready. So yeah, can you guarantee your results? Because if you can guarantee it, I'm ready to move forward.
You can bring off the role play. You can do something that no other salesperson does. You can bring up a guarantee. Suppose it's, you can even suggest it. I'm trying to get them up the yes ladder. I'm trying to get, imagine for, hey, if someone could guarantee the results you're looking for, ironclad in writing, how would that make you feel? That isn't
where I would sign up right away.
I'm sorry, what? I couldn't.
I say that if somebody can guarantee what I'm looking for, we got a deal.
What kind of guarantee are you looking for in order for us to do business? Let me, you mind if I'm so glad we're on FaceTime, sir. Could you mind if I write this down? This sounds important. Give me, what kind of guarantee do you need from me?
Well, let's say, you know, we're talking about, you know, real estate deal. Well, that I'm gonna be able to qualify to buy the house after a year of renting it, that I will have.
Hold on, slow down. This is great stuff. I love that you're sharing this with me. Thank you, sir. I don't get many people who are as honest and forthright as you. You must have a great background. What's your background, sir? What do you do for a living?
I sell dental floss.
Do you know anybody who sells used dental floss? Do you?
Yeah, I mean, I'm actually top three regional in the East Bumble Fuck division in Florida. Yeah, I rank third.
You're like my doppelganger, man. It's another doppelganger.
So, well, yeah, I mean, if you can guarantee that, and that we will, you know, be able to get into this place with 5% or less down, I mean, option money, well, I think we can move forward.
You think, you know, sir, I have two things here: that you can qualify in 1 year, and that you can get into the home with 5% down. I presume now, right? Okay. Anything else? I got two things here on this great list.
No, that's not that I can think of.
Okay, and if I could provide those two things, you'd feel comfortable enough, you and your lovely bride, to make a commitment today so we could do paperwork and move this forward?
Yeah, sure.
I'm sorry, what?
Yes, sure. We will move forward if you can guarantee.
And you strike me as, you're old school like me. You're a man of your word, aren't you?
I am. My word is my bond.
I knew that about you. I just had that feeling about you. Okay, off the role play. Okay, this is where people have a lot of trouble with my gut system. Getting the commitment. Give him whatever he wants. They're going to say all kinds of crazy stuff. Oh, I want them to give me the house and $20,000. I want to be able to buy it in 6 months, even though I haven't had a job in a year. You know, they're going to say all this stuff.
Just listen to whatever they want to ask. Because, I mean, people will ask for the most unreasonable and unrealistic things. People have unrealistic expectations. They just want to be heard, and then they need reassurance. So let's move to the second part. And can you guarantee that?
Yeah, you know, let's pretend from off the role play, by the way, just before we move to that next step, what is the best super stroke in the world that you can give somebody?
Take notes.
Oh, this is so great. You know, I so appreciate this. You mind if I write this down? That's how important I think it is. Thank you so much. I love writing down stuff like this. Thank you. It makes my job so much easier. Boom. That is a super. When you do that to people with the right acting, John and I were talking earlier. I can teach you all the psychology in the world, but if you sound like you're condescending or pandering, or what was that other great word we had today? It was another
passive aggressive, maybe
patronizing.
Patronizing. Thank you, John. Thank you. If you sound like you're patronizing, condescending, or you're being sarcastic, you've lost the sale. So you've got to be a good actor when you do this stuff too. Absolutely. So back in this role play, maybe Horace, maybe you want to do it with Horace for a minute.
Let's have the other people in the group do it. Let's have the guys, you know, participate a little more.
Absolutely. So you've got all these things, all these conditions on this guarantee. You know, you can't do the 5% guarantee. He says, well, I want to buy the house in a year, and I want to do it with 5% down. And you know, the guy does not have the job seasoning or the credit history to do that. But you've got a commitment already, so you know how to sell them. But now you know you can't keep that kind of commitment. How do you fix it? You're on, Horace. You're on the hot seat.
You are on.
Okay, so the guy can't keep the commitment as far as money.
Yeah, but you still want to close him. You've got the property. He's gonna. You want to get him in the house because it's been sitting empty. He wants to buy it and qualify in 1 year. Let me change it. He wants to qualify for a loan in 1 year, and he wants you to guarantee. And you know, there's no way it's going to take him 2-3 years minimum. And you want to get out of that guarantee. Of, you know, how do you get out of that with and still keep the deal going? He's got a bunch of money. He can afford the property, but he wants a guarantee that he's going to get a loan in 12 months. And you know, that's a guarantee you don't want to give.
Okay. So you mentioned that you have the money to get into it. Let me ask you a question. What happens at the end of the year and we come to a point that you see that you're not able to fulfill your part of this agreement? Do you want to wait till then to figure it out, or could we figure that out now?
I don't care. I just want to know. I mean, I'm giving you $20,000. I'm moving in this home with my wife and the 10 chihuahuas. I want to buy this home in a year. Can you guarantee that?
Definitely. So I understand what you're saying, that you're looking to buy and purchase in a year, based on, you know, what we've spoken about and the way where you're at with your credit. It honestly, do you want me to tell the truth, or do you want me to lie to you?
Well, always the truth. Yeah.
Well, perfect, sir. Based on what we've discussed so far, it seems like for you to own this house is going to be probably about 2 years or so. You say you want to purchase in a year. I mean, I could be a heathen and take your money and have you try to, you know, go through that process. But, you know, to save you time, to save me time, this property is not going to be a fit for you. If we could, you know, if I could get you in something that is going to be a fit for you, is that something that we could discuss a little further?
Yeah. Here's the thing. I've done stuff like this before, and I've always had trouble with the bank. I made a few mistakes in life.
Man, I could definitely understand that. You're not the only person that's went through this type of stuff. I've dealt with a lot of sellers and buyers that have the same situation. What I could do for you, if this is something that you really want to do, is I could put you in touch with a good friend of mine that handles that type of stuff and bring you up to speed as far as your credit and payments and stuff like that. And then I could look at putting you in a property that's going to be take you a little bit longer to qualify for. Is that something we can work on?
No, I want this home.
So what I'm hearing from you is that this area, you love the area.
To tell you the truth, my wife loves this home. I mean, do you think your guy could help me to qualify maybe in 2 years, 3 years on this home? You think if we did it that way?
In 2 or 3 years, I think, here's what we could do. Imagine
for a moment.
Good. Just imagine for a moment, you could move into this property in 2 to 3 years, your wife would be happy, your kids would be happy. You could have Sunday barbecues, smelling the ribs, having the family in the backyard, lounging.
Oh, beef or pork ribs?
Beef.
I love beef ribs. Oh, what with barbecue sauce dripping on my white shirt and everything?
Yes, with a little hint of spice to it.
Oh, yeah, and a big roll of paper towels. They get so messy, don't they? You love when your fingers in it, you're licking your fingers. I love barbecue. Oh, man. Is everybody hungry right now? Does everybody want those ribs?
So what we could do is we could lease this property for you for 2 years while you get all your stuff straight, and then we look at committing you to a purchase over that time. Is that something that will work for you today?
Yeah, I feel pretty good about you. What do I need to do next?
Okay, perfect. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go ahead and send over a lease agreement for 36 months, And what we're going to do is at the end of that term, we're going to get you I'm looking to do a lease option with an option agreement to purchase at the end of that 36 months. And in the meantime, I also want you to sign an addendum to make sure that you build your credit in order to come out on the back end, okay, being able to purchase a property.
You did great, by the way, but I wanted to hear a little reciprocity.
Okay.
You know, I want you to now ask a favor. You know, I'm so glad you asked great questions and everything like that. And I hope did I answer everything to your satisfaction, Horace?
Yes.
Because you sound like a good man. You made mistakes. Who hasn't? I want to help you and your family get in there. I appreciate the dialogue. I can't get you in 1 year, but between 2 and 3 years, if you keep your job, you pay your bills on time, you work on your credit, and I'm going to give somebody to help you. I'm going to do all these things for you so that hopefully, listen to my legal tone, hopefully you can buy that home in 3 years. I'm going to do all this for you. Could you do me one small favor today?
Yes.
Boom. That's reciprocity.
Gotcha.
Did you also hear? So I took all the things I'm doing for you and I complimented you. I stroked, I nurtured. Did you hear my voice tonality change, my inflection? I started to get a little softer. Could you do me? And I said, a little slower, a little softer. I said, could you do me one small favor today, please?
Yes.
This is acting. Sometimes you have to change. We don't talk about this a lot either. These are all new things, guarantee and tonality and inflection. Sometimes when you're trying to get something, you have to change your tone. You have to change your inflection, the speed, the pentameter. What is it? Iambic pentameter. The way you say your words. Slowly, softly, loudly. Oh my gosh, Horace, so good to speak to you. But could you do me one small favor? And this is acting. This is the way you keep someone's, what's the word?
So engaged.
Engaged. Good word. I was going to say attention. Your word is better than mine. Keep them engaged. And this is all going into their subconscious, all this stuff. And then you ask that favor and you get a set of time frame too. Go ahead, John, you close Horace. Set a time frame for that contract to get back.
I would, but I have to go get my daughter right now.
Okay, that's more important.
Family first, man. That's good.
You get your daughter and have a good week.
Yes.
Alex, you want to take a shot in the car?
Come on, man. Let's roll. Let's do it.
Okay, you got to close Horace. You're this close. Now you did a little reciprocity and you want to set a time frame for to get the contract back and to have a follow-up meeting.
Okay. Horace, man, thank you so much for taking time to chat with me on Friday. I got a bunch of things to do right now, but before I let you go, you know, if we're going to do this, I got to set some time aside. I got to push some other things on the wayside so I can get this done for you today. Of course, can you do me a favor?
Sure.
It's just a small favor, man. So, you know, like I said, I'm balancing a lot of balls and juggling a lot of things. I need to get this contract ready and I need you to sign that today. Can you get this back to me by 3:30?
Yes.
You can?
Yes.
Okay. And what I'd like to do is I'd like to set up a follow-up meeting at 3:30.
Thank you. Compliment.
Of course, thank you, man.
Always stroke. Make him feel like he just did the most brilliant, wonderful thing in the world.
Horace, man, thank you so much. I mean, honestly, you know, it's great doing business with somebody like you. You keep it simple.
Yep.
And I think you're going to do that. And I'm excited to do business with you.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah.
See how off the role play. I'm sorry to be nitpicking here.
Do it. Be nitpicking.
But these are the little micro moves that are so important. Get another human being to like and trust. These are the little, people don't compliment. Did you ever send a gift to someone? Claudia and I were just talking. We sent a wedding gift to a couple hundred bucks, young couple. We know the family, we know the father and mother, but I know the kids forever. We sent them a gift, couple hundred bucks. A year later, I'm still waiting for a thank you card. Okay. What happened to these people who I liked? Nice, cute couple, but they didn't say thank you.
A little bit of animosity, rubbed you friction wrong way. Yeah.
They went to the shithole of life, as far as I'm concerned. You know, I just sent you money, hard-earned money, and you couldn't even send me a text or an email or a handwritten card or call me up and say, Claude, you were way too generous. That was so nice of you. We'll put it to good use. We think so much. Do you know what? It's so easy to lose a sale or make a sale by these little micro moves.
It's called, you know, you have good business etiquette and you have great business etiquette, and those, like, the devil is on the details. Like, for example, I'm sending this thank you card with a $20 Olive Garden gift card to a seller that I know that, you know, like, we're gonna do business together, but you see those little details that nobody else is doing, and it doesn't cost you anything. It's an investment. The ROI, it's infinite. Like, for example, one thing, I've been a student of Claude since end of 2016. I always joke and say, like, I'm the slowest learner with the deepest pockets.
He started with me when he was 16 years old.
Yeah, you know what? I was in, like, rite of puberty. But I can tell you this. Every holiday, I get a Christmas card. I get, you know, like, stuff that it's. You know, like, we take it for granted because of all of this technology. And I can tell you this, you know, when you have a wife and all that, that goes a long way, because it's like, it shows that you care. And I think, what was it, like, what was his name? Dale Carnegie said that, like, people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. And even if we can, if it's a one call close, it doesn't matter. That person needs to feel super special during that interaction.
The one guy who wrote the car sales book, it's an old book, Joe Girald or something like that, the world's greatest car salesman.
The one from Ford, the one that outsold.
Everybody.
Oh, that guy was genius.
All he would do when he got a customer or prospect, he would get their birthdays, their anniversaries, their kids' birthdays, any graduation. He would get as much information, and he'd write. In the beginning, he did it himself. Then he hired somebody. Always send thank yous or congratulations on graduation or quinceanera or whatever the hell, you know, these little things. Do you think they'd buy a car from anyone else?
No.
It's such common sense. We've lost this ability to you know, we think we can automate the love of our children. You know, sometimes they just need a hug. You can't send them a text and get that same feeling.
Who was Gary V said, can you automate your mother's hug or something like that?
Yeah. Yeah. There's some things that are so, I'm one guy with no employees who works out of his home, who runs a very profitable business with very low overhead, only because our business model is some of the things we're talking about here today. Good communication, good follow-up, make people feel special. It's not that you don't need these thousands, you don't need to scrape thousands of leads and get a VA calling and then an acquisition manager. What's the other one? I always forget, Felipe.
We have acquisitions manager, integrator, transaction coordinator, disposition manager, COO, and everything under the sun. And I've drank that Kool-Aid, guys, and that shit doesn't, the bottom line, it's not good, not at all. I'd rather have a leaner business model.
Claudia and I went to the dentist yesterday. Yeah, okay, we both, this is the God's honest truth, okay? We both, I needed a filling, haven't had x-rays in over a year because nobody went to a dentist during COVID, I didn't. It was dangerous. I mean, you know, in the early March, we went to the dentist, we both needed no cavities, but we both got cleanings. I got a filling, x-rays. Take a guess. This will knock you out. Take a guess what the bill was. We wrote it. And I just write a check and I give it to them. They love me. I just write a check for the whole thing. Guess how much that was.
With the cleaning and what else?
Cleaning, x-rays, one little filling.
Like $2,000 probably.
Yeah, $2,000.
It was $1,000, $995. I mean, a $950. I think that's a lot of money for a dentist, but for one bit. And I said to Claudia, wow, that seems like a lot. And then we started justifying. Yeah, but she's a great dentist. They took us at their appointment. They're real friendly. It's super clean. It's state-of-the-art technology. And they give me, and we haven't been there in a year and a half. And so I thought it was a lot of money, but then they justified it. So 2000, you guys would pay 2000 for that. That's interesting. Maybe mom was right. I should have gone to dental school.
Yeah, I'm a bad person to ask. I just got a root canal a couple weeks ago. Oh, so
yeah. How much was my root canal last year, Claude? 1500? That was 1000 for a root canal I had too. But you know, and thank God, and I'm grateful to this business. Thank God. What do people do? Don't have that money, you know, for all these things.
90% plus of Americans don't even have $500 in a savings account to take care of an emergency. It's sad, but it's true. It's like if something breaks in your home today, 90 plus percent of Americans don't have enough money to fix it. If your car breaks, your AC, whatever. And that's because of, you know, like it's just people think that they can achieve freedom on, you know, working for somebody else or just grinding it on the corporate ladder for a couple of years. And it's never going to happen. It's never going to happen. I mean, and if you want to become an entrepreneur, if you really want to go on business on your own, the very first thing you need to learn before any of the other bullshit that the gurus are going to sell you of marketing systems and all that shenanigans, you just got to learn how to sell, learn how to persuade, learn how to talk to people, learn what makes people buy. And that it's, you know, that's 80% of the equation. Then the rest, I mean, I'm a royal disaster for everything else. Administrative, all of that stuff. I suck at it. But you know, but because I can talk to people, I get to pay outside consultants, or you know, like you get to pay for that help, just like the dentist that Claude says, like, oh yeah, you know what, this year I need to minimize my impact on taxes, or I need to just try to make sure that I invest my money well. You have enough money to pay an advisor to do that for you.
Exactly. Guys, I have to go to my next call here in a minute.